What's happening, Fringe fam? It's PK here in our gym in Austin, Texas. And today I'm gonna talk to you about a subject that is near and dear to my heart. How strong is strong? But before I get into that, I wanna invite you to join me in our private Facebook community, Garage Gym Revolution. It's filled with people like me and you who are trying to better their lives, live longer, happier, healthier lives through strength. Find the link in the comments below. Also, give us a follow on Instagram at Fringe Sport. All right, let's dive in. I'm 41 years old. I want to share something with you. I'm no longer chasing records in the weight room. There was a time in my life when I really wanted to be, I wanted to be strong, I wanted to go to the CrossFit Games, I wanted to destroy. That's not me anymore. Now, I'm just interested in one, being amazing on the soccer field, being fast for a lifter, strong for a runner, and being able to do anything that I want to do. But I obsessed when I was younger about how strong is strong. How strong should I, as a man, be? If you're wondering about this, I'm gonna dive in to how you can figure this out. And stick around to the end, because I'm gonna talk a lot about different strength standards and stuff like that. But at the very end, I'm gonna give you a real simple strength standard. All right, let's jump into this. So how strong is strong? If you ask a power lifter, he's gonna tell you one thing. If you ask a CrossFitter, they're gonna tell you another. Let's say a marathoner, ask a marathoner. They're gonna tell you something completely different. But there are a few people who I respect who have done some really good thinking on this matter. So let's start with Mark Ripito and Lon Kilgore. They've got a great book called Starting Strength. And in addition to Starting Strength and in some of their other work, they actually have strength tables where you can look at your body weight on one side, and then you can look at different lifts and what level your strength or those lifts would put you in. These days, they're leveling category one, category two, category three, but in the old days, they used to put the levels as untrained or novice, intermediate, advanced, elite. And so you can really look into that and you can say, okay, if I wanna be advanced or elite, I need to lift this much in bench press because I weigh this much. And by the way, because it's all based around body weight, there's a little cheat code in here. If you're just really interested in getting into the next category, sometimes you can cut a little bit of weight and then you can jump into that category. So the reason that I like these charts that Rip and Kilgore put out is because they are male and female, and they are based around your body weight. So you can really easy look through there and you can see where your strength should be. The other thing that I like is while Rip is a strength coach, I believe that these are more applicable to most people than, let's say, powerlifting charts. Okay, now let's move on to powerlifting. So if you're interested in how strong, it's super easy because powerlifters and all these different powerlifting federations have different strength standards for their different classes of lifter. And again, you're also looking at body weight based and male and female. That said, if you are interested in being strong for a powerlifter, there's a gentleman named Tim Henriques, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, who has got some strength charts out there that you should look at. The reason I like Tim's better than going to a powerlifting federation is that Tim is less focusing them on competition and more focusing them on just raw strength. Whereas if you go to a powerlifting federation, you're gonna find lifts that will put you in different categories for competition, which may or may not be what you're looking for. That said, I personally like Rip's strengths a little bit more because he comes from a background of training for sport. Whereas Tim comes from a background of training for the sport of powerlifting, which is all around strength. Speaking of training for sport, another great set of strength standards is by Dan John. So Dan John is a very respected strength and conditioning coach in the track and field area. The reason that I like Dan's strength standards is they're so easy. He lists expected strength and then game-changing strength. And so you don't have to worry about body weight, you don't have to worry about any of this stuff. hey, if you're a man, he expects you to have X level of strength, but if you can go to a different standard of Y, then you're at game changer level. So really easy to understand. And also, because he comes out of the background of track and field, he's not getting people strong just to be strong. He's getting people strong so that they can excel outside of the gym in their sport. So another great set of strength standards are those put out by Atomic Athlete. Now, I have a soft spot in my heart for Atomic because those guys are great friends and I train there. That said, what I love about their strength standards is that they are very much gearing their strength standards, more than any of the previous that I've mentioned, towards what an athlete can do in the gym that translates into their sport or life outside of the gym. And I have a soft spot for that because that's really what I'm interested in. I'm interested in training in the gym for my life outside of the gym. So you should definitely check those out. I will mention one soft spot on the Atomic strength standards is that they are very well fleshed out for male athletes, but not as well for female athletes. Additionally, for all of these strength standards that I mentioned earlier in this video that I'm 41 years old, most of these strength standards are not rated by age. So what I could lift at 25 years old versus what I can lift today at 41 versus what I'll be able to lift at 55, 70, 100 years old, that's gonna be wildly different. What is super strong for a 100 year old is probably pretty weak for a 25 year old. And again, these standards that I mentioned before are not graded by age. Okay, so those are a few strength standards and we'll link all those up down below, but we're coming to the end of the video. Pete, this is a lot of gobbledygook. I don't want to follow a link. I just want to know if I'm strong. All right, here is my four wheels standard of strength. When I was younger, this is the amount of strength that I had, which by the way, I don't lift this today, but when I was younger, I aimed to get above the four wheel standard of strength. And when I did, I felt that my strength was at a game-changing level, as Dan John might say. I felt that every activity athletically, and to a lesser extent, other things in my life, were really affected by this level of strength, and it's super easy. I wanted to bench two wheels, squat three wheels, and deadlift four wheels. What does that mean, Pete? Well, a wheel is a 45-pound weight plate. So benching two wheels means benching 225. Squatting three wheels, squatting 315, and deadlifting four wheels. That means deading 405. When I reached two, three, four wheels, I saw a massive flow through into my athletic events. I was strong. When I was running on the soccer pitch, I may not have been the fastest, especially because I was pretty darn strong, but boom, anybody went shoulder to shoulder with me, they went down because I was, boom, solid. So, I mentioned earlier a few different strength standards. Did I miss something? Let me know in the comments below. I'm really interested in this stuff, and I would love to see if I miss any of these awesome strength standards. What about my two, three, four wheels standard of strength? Do you disagree? What should it be for female athletes? Should it be one, two, three wheels? I actually don't know. So let me know in the comments below. And as a quick reminder, you can find me in the Garage Gym Revolution private Facebook group, link below, and find us at Fringe Sport on Instagram. I really love talking about the strength stuff. I wanna know, what do you think about what I said? Help me know in the comments below. Give us a like, give us a follow, and as always, lift heavy, lift happy,